Hi friend, welcome to the abstract algebra class. It is class 35. Here also we will prove a theorem which is about coset group, coset of a group theorem. If a comma b or any two elements of a group with G with respect to multiplication and H is any subgroup of G, then two cases, here is two cases. One, H A equal to H B, if and only if A into B inverse belongs to H. Here H A is the left coset generated by A in G, H B is the H A is the right coset generated by A and G, also H B is right coset generated by B and G. Similarly, second one, a left coset, H is left coset generated by A and G is equal to the left coset generated by B, if and only if A inverse into B belongs to H. Or we can say AH equal to BH if and only if A inverse into B belongs to H. Proof: let G with respect to multiplication be a group and H be any subgroup of G. G with the given multiplication as a binary operation is a group and H be a subgroup of G. Let A comma B or any two elements of a group G. First one, we want to prove the first one. To prove that HA equal to HB, if and only if A into B inverse belongs to H, we want to prove this. Since HA is right coset, it is right coset of H and G generated by A, therefore A belongs to HA. As a definition, according to the definition of right coset, we can write A belongs to HA. Since A belongs to right coset, suppose here the left side is true, HA equal to HB. Since A belongs to HA, here A belongs to HA, but HA equal to HB, A belongs to HB, HA equal to HA equal to HB. This implies A belongs to HB. This implies A, and we multiply both sides by B inverse. A into B inverse belongs to H, H into B into B inverse. This implies A into B inverse belongs to A by associative axiom, H into B inverse. This implies A into B inverse belongs to H, B into B inverse. Well, the result will be E. This implies A into B inverse belongs to H. A H into E is H. Therefore, H when H equal to E, H A equal to H B, this implies A into B inverse belongs to H. Converse of the theorem here. Now we assume that the right side is true. That is, suppose A into B inverse belongs to H. We prove the left side. A into B inverse belongs to H is implies H equal to H into A into B inverse. We know that. We know if A belongs to H, this implies H equal to HA. Therefore, A into B inverse belongs to H. This implies H equal to H into A into B inverse. This implies HB equal to H by, now we multiply both sides by B, H into B equal to HA into B inverse into B. HB equal to HA into B inverse into B. This implies HB equal to HA, B into B inverse into B, it will be E. This implies HB equal to HA. Hence, HA equal to HB. HA equal to HB if and only if A inverse, A into B inverse belongs to H. Here we assume that A into B inverse belongs to H. We prove that HB equal to HA. Therefore, we can conclude that HA equal to HB if and only if A into B inverse belongs to H. Second one, H equal to BH if and only if A inverse into B belongs to H. To prove that H equal to BH if and only if A inverse into B belongs to H. Okay, B belongs to BH. Now we suppose the left side, H equal to BH. Then we prove that the right side, this implies B belongs to AH. B belongs to AH. We multiply both sides by B. We get the A inverse. We multiply both sides by A inverse. We get A inverse into B belongs to A inverse into A into H. This implies A inverse into B belongs to A inverse into A into H. This implies A inverse into B belongs to H. Therefore, AH equal to BH. Here, when we say AH equal to BH, B belongs to BH. This implies B belongs to AH because both of these are equal. Therefore, instead of BH, we can write AH. So we conclude that AH equal to BH implies A inverse into B belongs to A. Converse of the second one, suppose A inverse B belongs to H. We prove the left side. Here A inverse into B into H equal to H. Where we know that? From here. We had if in the last theorem, we had the last lecture, we had if A belongs to H. This implies if and only if AH equal to H equal to HA. We had this theorem we proved in the last lecture. From here, instead of A, we have A inverse into B belongs to H. Therefore, A inverse into B into H. This one into H equal to H. We multiply both sides by A. We by the using associative axiom, we get A into A inverse into B H equal to A H. A into A inverse E into B into H equal to A into H. B H equal to A H. Hence from here, from these things, we suppose that A inverse into B belongs to H. We get BH equal to AH. Therefore, hence AH equal to BH if and only if A inverse into B belongs to H. This was the theorem which we proved that. Thank you.